I came across this interview with Andras Schiff talking about the French Bach suites, the Bach French suites, which he was about to play in Leipzig in a piano concert. You know Andras Schiff, the famous pianist, great Bach performer. And in that interview, which is magnificent, and I will share with you an excerpt, and the link of the full interview is in the description box, he talks about Bach and the clavichord. And don't judge him on that too soon, because Andras Schiff is a long time clavichord player. I shared an excerpt from that interview with you now, and I come back later with some personal thoughts about it.
Natürlich, damals, was für Instrumente hatte Bach? Also vor allem das Klavichord, das war sein Lieblingsinstrument. Und dann das Clavicembalo mit zwei Manualen. Ich bin ziemlich sicher, dass diese französischen Suiten Clavichord-Musik sind. Die sind sehr, sehr intim, sehr introvertiert. Und das Clavichord, das war ja das ideale Instrument fürs Wohnzimmer. Das könnten wir heute in einem größeren Saal gar nicht genießen. Das ist wirklich etwas sehr Privates, nur für den Spieler und maximum 3-4 Zuhörer. Und auf dem Klavichord konnte er so ganz leicht vibrieren, so ein Bebungseffekt, wo man den Finger auf einer Taste so vertikal bewegt. Und das gibt einen Effekt, so Vibrato-artiges Effekt. Deshalb ist das Klavichord ein viel feinsinnigeres Instrument als das Cembalo, was viel brillanter ist vielleicht. Also das ist mehr geeignet für ein Konzert, auch in der damaligen Zeit. Aber ich empfinde diese französischen Suiten so wie eine Art Hausmusik.
So that interview, you should watch it completely. I like the way Andras Schiff is talking so quietly in his own tempo, so different than today's information flow, which is fast and consumable and Facebook like, so to say. This is 30 minutes of just him reflecting on the music of Bach. But what he is saying about Bach and the clavichord, I would wish that I had the courage to say it myself. And it's so obvious. Just a few thoughts on that behind the back of the great Andras Schiff, so to say. I think it's time to change our mindset to that and look to the facts again. And it's not because people like Leonard, and I admire Leonard so much, really. I say this with the deepest respect, but they defended the harpsichord in a way that it's hard to say that it's based on facts, it's on personal tastes, and maybe also because of the fact that there are so little clavichords, and certainly back then, in the 16th and 17th, so little clavichords available that are built on a level that really let you taste what the clavichord is capable of. But if you look to the facts of the early 18th century around Bach, 1710, 1715, 1720, it's so obvious that the clavichord, and so the unfretted clavichord, was the instrument for the solo works. They were looking for expression. They were looking for an instrument to play in 24 keys. That's the reason why the instrument needed to be unfretted. They had to tune the instrument in a way that allowed them to play in 24 keys. That was the technical requirement. The harpsichord was an instrument that was capable of doing that. Obviously, it is by definition unfretted. But they chose the clavichord. Why? Because they needed an instrument that had a high level of expression, dynamics. And the clavichord, a good clavichord, gives you that. So if you look to the facts around Bach, then it's obvious that the harpsichord, as beautiful as that instrument is, was the instrument for the orchestra, for the accompaniment, for the solo parts in the concerto. What Andras Schiff said is so true. The solo works in that time, the Klavierwerke are mainly composed for clavichord. And I know the mindset of today is different. If you would say today, historically, you as a clavichord player, which is a term that's a neo-baroque term, it didn't exist in the 18th century, you are a keyboard player, but anyway, you play it on harps, on clavichord, you have to, you cannot prove that Bach wrote this for a clavichord. You cannot imagine how many times people are saying that to me. But it's the opposite. Looking from a bird's angle to the facts around Bach's life in a broader perspective, you should start proving, if you are interested in doing that, that it's mainly written for the harpsichord. I think that's against the nature of the facts and the development of history at that time. The unfretted clavichord was the modern instrument of that time. There are not so many instruments surviving from that period. That's true, because it was an elite instrument. Few people could play in 24 keys, and that's the reason why you needed an unfretted clavichord. It was not like today, when we have to learn play scales in all 24 keys at conservatories in the piano class. It was completely new at the time. So that there are maybe seven of eight or eight instruments, unfretted instruments surviving from that period, doesn't mean that Bach didn't have one. And in fact, and that's really the closure of this video, I will come back to that in other segments. It's so important, I think. Adlung, 1726, it was published, his work. Much later he talks about building organs and building a clavichord and some other instruments as well. But the clavichord part is really interesting. And as Joris Botvliege points out in his recent article on Bach and the clavichord, it's being published now in Clavichord International, that then the clavichord Adlung describes could well have been the blueprint of Bach's clavichord. It's so obvious. And as with many of those things, it's sometimes difficult to put your finger on the facts, but just putting one step back, creating a bigger perspective, many of those things are really easy or obvious at once. And so I'm not saying you cannot play this on harpsichord. Why would I say that? It can sound very beautiful on harpsichord in another way. I'm just saying that maybe we should turn around our way of thinking and look at the facts and not push the clavichord in the little corner that it is today. It was not there in Bach's time. The clavichord was at the highest position of any keyboard player's wish list. You were judged on your skills as a keyboard player at the clavichord, and it has a reason. I am very happy that people like Andras Schiff are expressing this. And again, not that I want to impose my opinion, so to say, to others. But it's sometimes not easy to just share the beauty of the clavichord because of this general tendency, the general mindset that it's obviously, of course, and we should get rid of these of course opinions for the harpsichord, which puts someone like me, who really likes it, to play it on clavichord a little bit in that corner. I want to get out of that. So that's a little bit of a statement video. I hope you don't mind. I'm sure you don't mind. And let's develop this a little bit more in the future. Thanks for watching. As always, it's snowing here. It's very cold. And sharing this video and subscribing as always. See you next time. Bye.